this working? Okay, now, Kirst, listen very carefully. I've got something very important to say to you. I've got to go away for a while.
Oh.
I'm leaving some very specific instructions for you.
But, Barney, I don't understand. Where are you going and why do you
Kirst, don't interrupt me. This is really important. Just as the Doctor had to become human, I've got to escape my role as presenter. More importantly, escape the family.
Hang on, the family? But, I mean,
Before I change, here's a list of instructions for when I'm away.
All right.
Number one, remember to say my lines as well as yours during the show. Number two, be nice to all our guests. Number three, always look directly into the camera when it's pointing right at you. Number four, don't hurt anyone. I know how you get when you're hungry. Number five, don't eat my private stash of cookies. And number 672, anything goes wrong, if they find me, open the watch.
Watch? Hang on, I haven't got a watch. Which watch?
That watch is me. I won't abandon you, Kirst.
No, but Barney, I haven't got a watch. I mean, how are you going to protect me from the family when I haven't...
And good luck.
Thank you very much. Great. So, this is ridiculous. I mean, there's no watch that...
Hello, son. I brought you some fruitcake.
Cooey, Barney, it's your nana. Get the kettle on.
It's your granddad. Have you had your hair cut yet?
Oh, no. It's Barney's family. Barney, where is the watch? Totally Doctor Who, which, surprise, surprise, isn't all about Barney's family. It's about the family. So to celebrate, we've got the really scary daughter of mine. She's not scary in real life, though. It's Lauren Wilson. Nice to have you here. But just as scary in real life, check out the scarecrows. They're weirding me out, man. There's more to them than just straw. We've got all your usual favourites as well. More from our animated adventure, The Infinite Quest. Are you enjoying that?
And for this week, a particularly special one.
Oh, you're back, are you? Yes, it is. Thank you very much. Also, our Totally teams have a bit of a set dressing challenge. Actually, speaking of dressing, I've got something for you to wear, young man. So I need you back in here right now. Quick, sharp. Thank you very much. Oh, what a strange smell. What is that? Oh, it's children. But they're human children. It's all right. Hi, guys.
Hi.
You're not scary at all. You can all stay, unlike the scariness of Daughter of Mine. Let's have a look at Daughter of Mine, played by Lauren Wilson. We want Lauren, we don't want Daughter of Mine. Come and join me. Phew, that's the real you now, isn't
it? Yes.
Excellent, because you started nice and then you were nasty, weren't you? What was that like?
I was definitely mysterious. Spooky and mysterious and sinister.
What was brother of mine or son? He was your brother, wasn't he? Or son of mine. What was he like? Because he had the wonky face, didn't he? And I was scared of him as well. Maybe I'm just a big wuss, but were you scared of him? What was he like?
He was independent and bossy.
Is that the real him or the character?
Both.
Now, what is your sense of smell like as Lauren?
Averagely human.
OK, we're going to be putting that sense of smell to the test a little bit later on. Do some sniffing for me now. You can't smell my armpits, can you? Actually, you can probably smell Barney Harwood's because he is quite literally on the move.
Now, I'm getting ready because I'm about to meet the Doctor Who choreographer. She's called Ailsa. She's going to show me some spins, maybe some kicks.
Hey, Barney.
Hey, Ailsa, how you doing?
Choreography on Doctor Who doesn't mean dance.
Oh, so what does it mean then?
It's the movement. It's the movement of the creatures.
Yeah, I knew that. I did. So let's talk about the monsters that you've choreographed on Doctor Who then.
There's been the Autons, followed by the Savines. We've had the Cybermen, the Oods. This time round, we have Pig Guards and Jadoon.
So let's not forget the Scarecrows over there. Now, they, of course, they're just bits of straw, really. How do you make straw move?
Well, that's the task. Not to make them look too comical, and at the same time, not to make them too lovable. They're sinister.
You've certainly got that down, that's for sure, yeah. It's very disjointed, isn't it? Very evil.
Yeah.
Well, listen,
yeah,
we're going to be learning a bit more about this later, because you're talking us through the actual movements of the Scarecrow. But now it's time to watch Team Totally. Keep an eye on them for me.
Yeah, of course.
It's time to watch Team Totally, because today they're immersing themselves in the Edwardian period and learning to dress a set. Here it is.
Welcome to Team Totally. Competing are Team Time Lord. They are... Cody, she plays four different instruments. Alia, he enjoys sleeping anywhere. And Sarah, who plays drums in a band. Up against Team Time Lord are Team TARDIS, and they are... Chris, who collects teddy bears. Molly, she wants to be a famous actress. And Daniel, who's a Welsh judo champion. For 12 weeks, our teams will have the opportunity to take away 2 points for winning a task and 1 point for being runners-up. The team with the most points will win a money can't buy Doctor Who experience. Who will win? Only time will tell. With only 1 point between them, the teams arrive at the Doctor Who studios to be given a set dressing task.
Set dressing is making sure that all the props and furniture and any other bits and bobs, any colours and materials that you want to put in a set, match and represent the feel of a time.
And being the art department coordinator on Doctor Who, Matt North is the ideal person to be setting and judging the set dresser challenge.
Hello everybody, welcome on set. For two of our episodes, the Doctor turns himself into Mr. Smith, the human. Now, one of the sets that features a lot is Mr. Smith's study, which is an Edwardian study room from about 1900 to 1913. Your task is going to be to try and recreate that set. So what you're going to need to do before you even get to touch some of the props is go away, do a bit of research and find out exactly what would be in a 1900 study.
Choosing furniture from the wrong time period could be the difference between winning and losing the task.
If I was you, I wouldn't sort of stick this in. This is more modern.
So our teams make sure they've fully researched the Edwardian period.
They didn't have double glazing.
No, they didn't have double glazing.
Using what they've found out, the teams must create a set that reflects the Edwardian period. Both teams have an identical set and props to dress it with, as well as members of the art department to help carry heavy furniture.
The desk would definitely be here.
The desk can be in the middle there.
It's not like a sit, but
look,
like
let's
that.
Go.
Put it in the middle on the carpet. Like, if we put the carpet there,
yeah.
Come put the carpet there, please.
Yeah.
That little one.
No, that's in colour.
Oh, yeah, that's in colour. Okay.
Taking it one piece at a time, Team Time Lord have started dressing the sides of their set, whereas Team TARDIS are starting in the centre.
The two wooden ones, the other ones...
Because that's his, like, office. Then opposite him could be the bookshelves.
We should just put the big one there, because it doesn't fit, and then put the small one by the chair, because they don't fit.
OK.
Well, Team Time Lord still have a lot of space to use, but Team TARDIS's set is quickly taking shape as a study.
Not like this.
Wait, take them two out. Because that won't fit otherwise.
And should we take all the books off, Cody?
Could you take the duck?
Is that... Can you put it through? Do you think I've got my stuff?
Yeah, that's good, because that's meant...
Oh, that's a bit weird.
Or should we put it above that, the door? Those doors?
No, I don't think that's...
Team TARDIS aren't ducking out of making their set look busy, whereas Team Time Lord seem to have forgotten the middle of theirs.
Could I put them in the little ones?
Yeah.
Has Sarah made a mistake, as the cup she's holding don't look very Edwardian?
What else do you think?
This is a picture of Winston Churchill.
Yeah.
Because that was the wall.
It's a good job Team Time Lord are paying attention to detail, as Team TARDIS could be about to undo all their hard work with a picture from the wrong time period.
That's good.
What do you think?
Yeah, Winston Churchill, I think, would do.
Okay, we're
good.
Yeah.
Two books there.
Whoa! Oh, BGM!
You're playing fine.
Right, team, time's up.
The teams had to dress a set as an Edwardian study. Team Time Lord only dressed the edges of their set and left the middle very empty.
I'm very happy with the room that we dressed, because it was simple and it wasn't too crowded.
Team TARDIS, however, created a busy set, but not all their props were of the right time period.
It was hard to, like, find out what was Edwardian or not, because some things looked Edwardian, but... they actually weren't.
Who will win? Stay tuned to find out later.
I have to say, I thought they were both great. I wouldn't like to be in Judge Matt's decision, but he's got to make a decision. And you can find out what that is a bit later in part two of Team Totally.
Barney, I need you for this as well, please.
Come
what we've done, we've got some things under these platters here, and they could be a nice smell, they could be a horrible smell. It's your job to work out what they are. So blindfolds on, please, and prepare for your first...
I'll put mine on. All right, got it.
...stench. Are you set? Dun-dun-dun. Have a whiff.
Whiffing.
This smell. What do you think it is?
Oh, I actually know what that is.
It smells... lettuce salad or something.
Lettuce and salad, good guess. Bon?
I worked in a hotel and I hated this stuff. It's either Stilton or blue cheese.
Have a look. You're both right. Weirdly. Very, very good. There it is. Lettuce. and some blue cheese. Next one coming up. Thank you very much for that. Thank you, Mr. Scarecrow. Let's give you that. What do you think this is? Have a whiff.
Yeah.
It smells mud.
What is
like?
It?
It smells of mud.
Football boot.
Have a look.
They smell of shoes.
Oh, this is
it's a stinky shoe.
Nice.
And finally, here we go. Next one. Clanging away there. Thank you very much. Have a whiff of this. Get your schnozzers in there.
That smells like they have on the farm.
What do you think it is?
Hay.
Hay?
No. Wait, yeah, muddy hay.
Smells like hamster. I've no idea.
Have a look.
A hamster that's been jogging.
It was
You're not feeling any lighter, are you, Mr. Scarecrow? That's not yours.
Well, I'm pleased to announce all your nostrils are fully functioning. Well done.
Thank you very much. I'm pleased to announce a very special behind-the-scenes treat now. Can I do it?
Yeah.
I was asked to take part in the Doctor Who animation and play the voice of one of the characters in it. So here you are, Barney Harwood, starring alongside David and Freeman. How cool. I am so excited because I've got a part in The Infinite Quest. I'm going to be starring alongside the Doctor and Martha in my very own Doctor Who adventure. I'm here at the sound studios where I'm about to do the voice for my character. The only thing is, I don't know who or what I'm going to be yet.
There she is. So small I could reach out and crush it.
We all know that David Tennant is the Doctor and that Freema plays Martha. But in this episode, there's also Lizzie Hopley, who's the Mantas Vidic Queen, and Stephen Mayo as Pilot Kelvin. But their characters don't look anything like them. What's in store for me? Well, the best person to ask is the director. So, Gary, what am I doing today?
You're playing the really important part of radio control voice.
Radio control? I like
Absolutely.
The sound of that. And am I good-looking? Am I a handsome man?
I think you're sophisticated, elegant, like one of those World War II fighter pilots.
Well, for a role of this size and epic quantity, I may need some expert advice.
Whoa! What are you exactly?
Now, I've got the brief from Gary, and he says I should be a World War I sort of pilot voice.
Right.
And I'm playing a controlling voice as well, so I need to put those two together and make it authoritative. How would you do that?
Don't ask me for acting advice. I have no idea.
Oh, you're my only hope, man.
I'm not the person to ask. Cup of black coffee and a deep breath. That's what I do.
Coffee, deep breath. Mm. Okay. And maybe is there a stare? Because you have that doctor stare. And when you do that, the acting really kicks
in.
But this
is audio. You can't do that on audio. Right. We can't see you.
So I need to put
doesn't mean you can keep your hat on, though.
I can keep the hat on?
Keep the hat on,
well,
yeah.
Well, good, because that sort of keeps all the brainwaves in. It's soundproof as well, you know. So
sure, sure.
So that'll work better for the voice. OK, well, I'll go and have a quick practice.
Yeah, good luck.
And I'll see you in there.
Good
thanks.
Luck.
Thanks for that.
He's not got a hope.
All right, guys, should we go for it?
Yay!
You might. I've got that out.
Freema, how's it going through there?
Yeah, it's really good, actually.
Now, I was watching you before through the glass window, and I noticed that when you're actually talking, you're almost turning to the actors and still acting it out as well. So is that a tip that I should pick up from you there?
I mean, I was looking at the other actors. Not all of them do that. However, they had to come up and move my mic because as I keep doing this, I'm going off mic.
OK, so top tips today that I've picked up from David is wear a hat and drink coffee, and from you, stay facing the microphone.
Stay facing the microphone, okay. Yeah.
Held their Queenie hostage! But we asked to admit you got us beaten.
Doctor.
Pilot Kelvin, imperative you open a visual link to this helmet's communication system now. Please respond.
Roger. Link being established in 10. Spatial disintegration aborted. All units be on alert to apprehend male human. Codename Dr. Uar.
Beautiful. Thank you.
That's that episode done. Well done, everyone.
Hello, fellow voice actors. How was that? I really enjoyed that. Did you like it? Was it good? Did we do okay?
I think you got away with it. Yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah. Yeah.
Oh, sorry, one second. I was getting a phone call. Sorry, this is quick, isn't it? I asked for an audition earlier on. Hello? Hi. I'd love to read for the Doctor.
I've got to speak to my agent.
Very excited about having some lines in the Doctor.
How many lines was it again?
It doesn't matter how many lines there are, it's how important they are, you see? Oh. I have lots of important lines, me. Like this one. Who goes there?
No, you don't have to do the music bit. We've got some music especially for it.
Bam, bam, bam.
You don't sing over it and
sorry,
ruin it, man. It's your chance to get hold of a totally Doctor Who sweatshirt, as modelled by Lauren, Scarecrow and gang up there.
Beautiful, thank you.
All you need to do is, well, why don't you tell him?
You listen to me, Red. Now what you got to do is look out for this screen, because behind it there's going to be a Doctor Who monster in silhouette form. I'll go and get him.
Right.
Out you come. Oh, hello.
My, what big ears you have.
I'm allergic to cheese.
Very Ooh, strange. Anything else you can show us?
Yeah, how about that?
Oh, it must be like looking in a mirror, Barney.
A little bit. Tell you what, with this light on back here, it's bacon behind here.
So can you work out what exactly that is? If you can, either write to us with your answer, the address is on the screen right now, or you could email us, totallydoctorwho@bbc.co.uk, again, with your answer. And congratulations, by the way, if it's your name you can see on the screen right now, because you've got one of these. Oh, I missed it.
What was that?
It's a Totally Doctor Who sweatshirt. It's for you.
Ready?
Sirens
going off. I didn't do anything. It's time now for the Doctor Who animation. It's very exciting. The Doctor and Martha are still in search of the data chips and they're stuck on the planet Maiar. Turns out Queen Mantisfid, she's the invader of the planet. What?
You're in it.
I know, I'm in it. I'm the control voice. Listen out for that part. It's really cool. Stop it. You're too kind. Thank you very much. And make sure you watch next week to find out what kind of creatures live under the ice.
Oh, it's not like it's gone to his head or anything, is it, Lauren?
He's a lovey.
You're not a lovey, though, are you?
No.
That's good news. Our Wall of Fame is shaping up very, very nicely. Look, remember, you can win all of these at the end of the series simply by answering 12 questions. We are now up to question 8. I'm not going to give you that. Lauren's going to give you it. But first, we need you to add your handprint into there, please. Let's just hold that up and get your hand pressed in there. It's really, really hard doing this. In fact, if I had my weight on, there we are. OK, we'll add that into the collection. And we are now ready for question 8. So can I have some tension music, please? Lauren, prepare yourself.
Into which cottage did the Doctor, Martha and Joan escape?
That was fairly evil. That was like Daughter of Mine was back then. I was fairly scared. Of course, you know the answer, because you were there, but keep it tight-lipped. Don't give it away.
Yes, please do keep that tight-lipped, because we don't want anyone finding out the answer, of course, because you need to find that out by watching the next episode of Doctor Who. If you've missed any of the questions so far, get onto the website pronto. You'll find them all there, and then you can answer all of them. And don't forget, there are 4 more questions, and then you can win yourself those handprints. Now, that should have given Kirsten enough time to get down from the TGR and hopefully get an exclusive for us. Kirsten, nearly there yet?
Nearly there, but I am in heels, after all, you know. But hopefully, around this... There he is! Excuse me.
Oh, hello!
Hello, the man himself, David. Everything's
good.
Cool?
It's good, yeah.
Excellent. I want to speak to you, first of all, about that last episode about you being human.
Yeah.
How was that, suddenly playing human?
Well, it's like playing a completely different character, you know. I've been playing the Doctor for all these months, and suddenly it's this bloke called John Smith. He's got a different suit and everything.
You were playing around with loads of young actors in this one. We've got Lauren in the studio. How was that?
Oh, yeah.
Like a big bun fight? Having so many young actors on set.
It was great. It was good fun, actually. It was lots of youthful energy, lots of exuberance.
Ah!
Yes, it was good. It was good.
And the big thing I wanted to speak to you about, Nurse Redfern, and you.
What are you suggesting?
Bit of romance.
Listen, John Smith's a human being.
But what about poor Martha?
You know, he's not doing it maliciously. He doesn't realise that he's been travelling through time and space with her, does he?
What about the scarecrows as well? Because I am quite frightened of those.
I know, well, I think often the scariest things, though, are the everyday things that just go a little bit peculiar. Mm.
We had a brilliant drawing done for us by Russell of a scarecrow as a kind of allusion to what was coming.
Ah, OK, all right.
Do you think you could do a drawing now for us of something we can look forward to?
Of a future episode?
Yeah. Because that way you're not telling us, you're not breaking any contract rules. Just draw it for us.
This is quite a hard thing to do.
What you got? It's a face. Is that it? Are you pleased with that, aren't you? Very happy.
I'm very pleased with that, yeah. And it's slightly obscure.
Yeah.
And admittedly, won't make any sense to anybody watching. But if you, you know, watch this back in a few weeks' time, it might.
Might?
Yeah.
You can't even be confident it will.
Well, I don't think that could confidently transmit anything to you.
Thank you very much. We'll keep that safe. Right now, though, it's time to find out about the set dressing challenge. How are our teams getting on?
How are our teams getting on?
Our two teams had to dress a set as an Edwardian study, like that in the episode where the Doctor became human. Team Time Lord dressed the sides well, but left the middle empty. Team TARDIS created a busy set, but not all the props were of the right time period. So, are our teams happy with their efforts?
I'm really happy with our room because it looks really authentic and like it should do. It would mean quite a lot to us too, because it would be a confidence booster.
What did Matt the Judge think of Team Time Lord's set?
Oh, it's really nice. It's got some nice touch in here. You've used the furniture really well. It's nice to see some of the old pictures as well. The first thing that I have seen, though, this crockery. It's a bit too late for our period. I'd say that's about 1960s, 1970s. So looking at the desk, the first thing I can see, it says 1953. This is 1913, remember, but Doctor's good at time travelling, not quite that good. But everything else looks good. The only thing I would have suggested is for filming purposes, you might want to put the desk somewhere in the centre just so the camera can go all the way round. But apart from that, guys, really good effort.
It's mixed feedback for Team Time Lord. Is there room for Team TARDIS to take a win?
I quite like the duck. That's one of my little favourites there, so that's really nice. One thing I have noticed, you've put a set of books upside down. A camera might just notice that because there's no top to them.
Okay.
Everything else looks good, apart from you fell for Mr. Churchill here, because he only became really famous in the Second World War.
And this chair was also wrong. It's from the 1970s.
So that's a lot later. I really like what you've done with the desk. It's nice that it's in the middle. It really helps so the camera can move around. But I think now it's time to get the other team in and see who's the winner. It's been a really difficult choice. Really had to think hard about it. But I think the winner of this week's 2 points is going to be... this team.
Yeah!
We feel really great that we've won the set dressing task, and I'm just really happy. It's the loss of words.
I don't feel really bad about losing this challenge because I don't want them to feel too much like they've lost in any challenges.
So with a 2-point win, Team TARDIS bring the scores to 12 points each. Stay tuned. Make sure you watch next time to see who'll be one step closer to winning the ultimate Doctor Who experience. Oh, top work to Team TARDIS there. Well done. Right, we've got Ailsa with us, who is the movement coach on Doctor Who. Gave the Scarecrows their brilliant lolloping movements. How did you do that?
The legs stay straight and they swing round so they're all the time overtaking one another.
So one leg over
on the heel. That's it.
Do the arms swing?
Just let them go. Just let them go.
Feeling like a scarecrow, Bob. I can't actually stop now. I'm just going to keep lolloping.
That's fair enough. You keep lolloping. You lollop away. Honestly. Now, listen, we've got a bit of a challenge for you, Elsa, as soon as you're here.
OK.
Our smiley faces. Hello, smiley faces. They've drawn some monsters they'd like to see in Doctor Who. And so we thought, with you being here, maybe you could bring some of them to life for us.
Yeah, let's have a look. This looks very interesting. Almost looks like a seahorse type of creature.
Look at that big beaming smile on Jack. That's your picture,
is that
isn't
yours?
It? OK, nice.
It's a sea world monster. It guards the gates of the sea.
Wow.
And it hypnotises people and brings them into the water.
How did you imagine it moving?
It kind of, like, it moves very slowly and goes into a puddle and...
just really nice, flowing, and just still.
Yeah. What else, Elsa?
Oh, this is interesting, the Thunder Dragon. That's down on all fours.
Yeah, that's Billy's picture, OK. Do you want to try this, Billy?
Yeah.
Yeah? OK, yeah. Then. Elsa, how do you do it?
Let's go down onto all fours. Here's the starting position. Now, when my right hand goes forward, my left knee will come forward. And then when my left hand goes forward, my right knee will come forward. So you get it moving along in opposition.
Shall we give this a go? Go on then, so, right, left. Oh, hello, Simon's going off. Nobody panic, nobody panic. It's actually a good thing, that is, because it's now time to get a sneak peek of the next episode of Doctor Who.
Sister of mine, they're such a small little thing. Find a way in and spy on them.
How cool does that look? Watching that next time.
Lauren, anything else we should look out for?
There's a... can't taste too much, but there's a certain spaceship she definitely recommend.
Oh, nice tip.
Oh, thank you for that. Thanks so much for coming in with your big red balloon. And Ailsa, thank you to you as well, and our scarecrows, and you guys.
And of course to you at home for watching, and we'll see you next time.
Bye!